The 95% love stagnation. It's all about, you know, clinging to the safe harbor of the known, living out the best years of your life, watching television in the subdivision. Stagnation, the same conversations with the same people, the same books, the same kind of work, the same thinking. Why? Because they're frightened to go out into the blue ocean of possibility. But Papa Walenda, the great high wire walker, said it so well. He said, life is lived out on the wire. The rest is just waiting. Shift from stagnation to optimization so that everything you touch gets better, so the books you read get better, so the things you think get better, so your conversations get better, because if you're the smartest person in your social circle, today is the day to start a new social circle, to shift from the past into the beauty of the future. You see, the average people, the 95% cohort, it's all about the past. Well, here's the kind of athlete I was back in 1922. And then they start blaming their past for why their lives are not working. But if you're addicted to your past, of course you're never gonna do anything amazing in your future. And the game changer is all about a bold and brave and gorgeous future, making every day better than yesterday, making the coming year better than last year, even if last year was the single best year of your life. Now, we all get heartbroken, we all get hurt, we all experience adversity. So the real key is to see the past as a university toward mastery. Basically, ask yourself, how can I leverage the heartbreak? How can I leverage my trial? How can I leverage that dark time in the valley of pain that I went through 2 years ago or last year to bring on more humility, more bravery, more humanity, more light, more love, more mastery into the world?